Hey everyone, welcome to the top 10 list. Welcome to my top 10 favorite Stephen Frears movies. Yes, Stephen Frears is a great, elegant, classy filmmaker, and I thought, for no reason at all, I should do my top 10 favorite Stephen Frears films. Because you know what? I haven't talked enough about his movies, and he has a lot of great films, and they all deserve to be talked about, so let's get to it. Here's my top 10 personal favorite Stephen Frears movies. And yeah, and as always, before a top 10 list, you gotta have your honorable mentions. My honorable mentions are Failsafe, Hero, The Hit, The Program, and Sammy and Rosie. Yes, all good films. She can make the top 10 list, but David, my top 10 was my number 10. My number 10 is last year's Florence Foster Jenkins. Florence Foster Jenkins stars Simon Helberg from The Big Bang Theory. It has Hugh Grant and Meryl Streep as the lead character. Basically, it's about the story of this older lady, and she basically has a dream to be an opera singer, and so she becomes an opera singer. Problem is, she is an awful, dreadful, garbage singer, but no one has the heart to tell her because she's just such a sweet old lady and stuff. Her husband doesn't have the heart to tell her and stuff, and she is just an awful and painful to watch singer, but again, no one has the heart to tell her and stuff, so she goes through all these Broadway shows and stuff, and people are just like, what the hell am I watching and stuff, and yeah, this is actually a very enjoyable movie with great performances by everybody. Meryl Streep, who did not deserve the Oscar nomination. She's fantastic. It's Meryl Streep. It's fucking Streep. Meryl Streep's amazing. She never gives a bad performance. I do not think she deserved a nomination over Amy Adams for Arrival, but she was very good in this movie, and she played a very good part, and she was really funny in this film. Hugh Grant was also fantastic in this film. Simon Helberg was fantastic. The production, the costumes look good. Stephen Frears' direction is really good. It's just a very delightful, very funny film, and yeah, I enjoyed it. Coming number 9 is this year's Victoria and Abdul. Victoria and Abdul stars Judi Dench and a lot of other actors that I don't really know their names. Basically, it's a story about Queen Victoria and her friend. She befriends a Hindi named Abdul and stuff. He's there to basically serve the kingdom for just like a couple days and stuff. But then when she finds him, she kind of finds him pretty attractive and stuff. Then they just, you know, blossom this friendship, and he like teaches her Hindi and stuff, and he teaches her all about the culture and his language and stuff. He learns more about politics. He even gets like a status in like her group and stuff, and yeah, it's just a really delightful friendship between Victoria and Abdul, and it ends very dark and very tragic. I won't spoil anything, but this is actually a really well-made movie and a very well-written film, and I don't know the actors who plays Abdul, but he's absolutely fantastic. He has amazing chemistry with Judi Dench. Judi Dench, as always, is fantastic. It's a very great film, funny film, deep film, dramatic film, well-acted film. It's got beautiful costumes and production. It's an elegant film because it's a Stephen Frears film, and yeah, absolutely love it. Coming number 8 is Tamara Drew. Tamara Drew is a very overlooked indie art house comedy. It has Gemma Arterton in the film, and she's fantastic. There's not much else to say without spoiling this film, but again, if you like indie sort of British films and you love Stephen Frears' style, you're going to absolutely love this film. You'll love the comedy, you'll love the drama, you'll love Gemma Arterton's performance. She's not always good in a lot of films like Clash of the Titans or Prince of Persia, but she's really fucking good in this movie, and it's just a really good film, really well-made film, and yeah, absolutely loved it. Coming number 7 is Mrs. Henderson Presents. Mrs. Henderson Presents stars Judi Dench. Yeah, this is almost like a Judi Dench list because she's been in a lot of Stephen Frears films. Yeah, it has Judi Dench and Bob Hoskins and Kelly Riley. This is basically during, you know, post-World War and stuff, and it's about Judi Dench. She loses her husband, and she wants to open her own Broadway show. She wants to open a theater and have a lot of plays and Broadway shows and stuff. And she hires Bob Hoskins to be a producer on the show, and, you know, run all the shows, run all the musical numbers and stuff. And their theater starts off as a success, but then it starts losing business. So Judi Dench wants to try something different, so she starts putting nudity. Yes, puts nudity in the Broadway shows, and it's very controversial and stuff, but they become a hit because, you know, people are perverted. They don't want to see an actual show. They just want to see the nudity and everything. This is based on a true story, and it's a very interesting, very controversial story. It's fascinating. Bob Hoskins is in this movie. He's fantastic. Christopher Guest, Kelly Riley, and Judi Dench are all amazing in this film. It's very funny. It's very dark, very controversial, but it's a delightful watch, and yeah, I thought it was a really good film. Coming number six is Dirty Pretty Things. Dirty Pretty Things is another really dark, very unwatchable, kind of disturbing film. It's about immigration and stuff, and a little bit about poverty and low class and high class and stuff. But and then it takes place mostly in this hotel and everything. And it has stellar performances by Audrey Tautou and Chiwetel Ejiofor. Both amazing in this film. This is another film that is a really compelling, very hard movie to watch. And a film that I will not dare spoil or talk about, especially the ending, the third act of this film. Wow! I just can't say anything, but this is a fantastic film, a riveting watch, a well-directed, well-executed film. It's very dark. It's not like a classy, elegant film like in Victoria and Abdul. It's not like, this is probably the most different and very unique Stephen Frears films out there. He went really all out with this film, and it is a damn great film. It is a one-and-done for sure, but it is a damn good film. Give it a watch. Coming number five is Dangerous Liaisons. Dangerous Liaisons is based off a novel, which I have not read, and there's been multiple adaptations for this, like Valmont and Cruel Intentions, the teenage version. Dangerous Liaisons is basically about this guy and this woman. They always like run bets with each other and stuff, and basically the lady dares him to, the guy Valmont, to, you know, this girl to fall in love with him and basically break her heart and stuff because she's like a virgin and everything, and yeah. It's a very cruel movie, again, it's called Dangerous Liaisons. These are very despicable characters, but the character learns to love and feel and stuff, but then it backstabs him in the back when he, you know, goes into the duel at the end and gets killed and everything. This has John Malkovich, Michelle Pfeiffer, Glenn Close, Keanu Reeves, Uma Thurman, a lot of great cast members. They're all fantastic, especially John Malkovich and Glenn Close, both amazing in this film. Production, the costumes, the elegance, the direction, the cinematography, all fantastic. Definitely watch this version over Cruel Intentions and Valmont. Those are, I guess, okay films, but this is the original story, actually based off the actual book. Check it out, see for yourself, it's a good movie. Coming number four is Philomena. Philomena, yes, another Judi Dench movie. Yes, Judi Dench is in this movie with the actor Steve Coogan, who I think co-wrote this film, and this is a fascinating film. This is a very interesting story about a girl. She grew up like within this nunnery and stuff. She was going to be like a nun, but then she got pregnant. She had to give up her baby and stuff, and basically now she's an older lady. She asks the help of Steve Coogan to help find her lost child. She's an old woman now, her child must be like 30, 40 years old, and basically they go on this like adventure journey with, they go on this journey together to help find her son or daughter that she gave up. I think it's her son actually. And she's looking for her son that she gave up, and she wants to find out where he is and who he is and if he's okay and everything, and basically tell him why she had to give him up and everything. And the ending to this movie is just downright sad. And when you find out the real truth about everything, it's just a really sad film. And Judi Dench is absolutely fantastic. So is Steve Coogan. The writing for this movie is really good. I love this relationship between Steve Coogan and Judi Dench. It's a very funny relationship. It's a very dramatic relationship. They both fantastic. They both have great chemistry with each other. They both work perfectly off each other. It's just a really damn good film. And yeah, it's a very overlooked film, I think, in my opinion. It's one of those Oscar contenders, but it's a movie that a lot of people didn't watch. It's a really good film, actually. It surprised me. When I was about to first watch that film when it came out, I'm like, oh, this is just going to be another Oscar-baity film. But no, it was actually a very compelling watch, and I actually genuinely love the film, and I think it's damn good. Coming number three is The Grifters. The Grifters stars Annette Bening, John Cusack, and Angelica Houston. This movie is a straight film noir. It's a neo-noir because it's all in color and stuff, but it's got the femme fatales, it's a crime story, and the movie even acts like it's a classic 40s film noir. And it's fascinating, this movie. Some people might think of it as like a comedy and stuff because how the characters are acting in the film. They act like it's a film noir. Like, say, what are you going to do here, eh? Like, it is a straight film noir, but it's a modern film noir, which makes it a neo-noir. I love this movie. I think this is such a great film with a great twist, which I will not spoil. Great performances. It's basically about these people who rip people off. John Cusack rips people off. He gets it from his mother, who also rips people off, and she works for the mob and gets into some crazy shit. Then there's Annette Bening, who is stunning in this movie. She looks amazing in this film, and she also rips people off. She used to work with guys and stuff. She uses her body and her looks to rip people off. She wants to team up with John Cusack so they can double team people, but he doesn't want to do that. He wants to get out of the grifting life and everything. this is just a great film. Great performances, great direction. I love how they played a straight homage to classic film noir. I absolutely love this film. This is definitely one of the most unique and clever Stephen Frears films, and it's definitely one of my favorites. Coming number two is The Queen. Yes, The Queen. Yes, this doesn't have Judi Dench. This has Helen Mirren instead. Helen Mirren plays the Queen Elizabeth in the film, and this is basically during her... basically, her last years in office and stuff, because this is when they get, like, Prime Minister. They get the Prime Minister, Michael Sheen, in the film. Basically, he's going to be running the country instead of Queen Elizabeth, mostly. And basically, it's about her relationship with Michael Sheen and stuff, how they don't like each other, but then they grow to respect each other. It's also about her life, her family life, how she had to deal with death and loss and everything. It's a fascinating film. Some people might find it a very boring, very political film. I love it. I love political films about, you know, historical icons like Queen Elizabeth and everything. Helen Mirren is amazing in this film. She gives a wonderful performance, a very Oscar-worthy performance. Michael Sheen was also terrific in the film. They worked amazingly off each other. It's a wonderful story, really well-paced, and yeah, it's just a delightful film. And my number one favorite Stephen Frears film is High Fidelity. High Fidelity is his most different film because it doesn't feel like a Stephen Frears film. It's not dark and disturbing, and it's not elegant and classy or British. It is a straight comedy film. It is a good dramatic comedy film about John Cusack basically running his own music store and, you know, hanging out with his friends and stuff, and he's talking about his past relationships and why they haven't worked out. Gives his top five favorite, his top five worst breakups and his top five everything and stuff, and it's just a really good, hilarious film. I love this movie. I think it's fantastic. John Cusack gives one of my favorite performances John Cusack gives. Jack Black is amazing. He's probably the show stealer in this film. I love this movie. Even Tim Robbins is just a weird gives a weird performance in this movie. It's got a great soundtrack. If you're a big fan of music, you'll probably love this film. This movie is all about the music and stuff, and how these characters just are obsessed with music. That's all they talk about is music. It's almost like Clerks for music and everything, and it's just an awesome film. I absolutely love this film. I love everything about High Fidelity, and I love that Stephen Frears directed this movie. This feels more like a Steve Pink film, not a Stephen Frears film, but he did it, and he did an amazing job, and it's hands down my favorite movie he has directed. So yeah, that was my top 10 personal favorite Stephen Frears movies. So in the comment section below, please tell me, did you agree to this top 10 list? If not, give me your top 10 personal favorite Stephen Frears movies. Comment below, let me know. And as always, for this video, please like, subscribe to this channel, and join the dark side.